Last week, these two streets of Zolote-4, which is called Vinly Village by the locals, were filled with the Russian militants. They conducted attacks on Ukrainian positions from this settlement. The occupiers won't have the opportunity anymore. Our soldiers have liberated the town and control the territory now.
There are around 150 people living in Vinly Village. According to Arena, the Russian-led militants were frequent guests here.
They came in groups of 3, 5, and 7, walked around the settlement and left. I am for Ukraine.
Having lived in a contested gray zone for 4 years, the people are happy with the arrival of the Ukrainian soldiers. God forbid we end up in a gray zone. It's better to have our soldiers in charge. The locals feel protected and the occupiers are not as aggressive. Now we know who protects us for sure. Before, we weren't so sure. Oleg tried to leave his home as rarely as possible. A year and a half ago, his brother was killed by a militant sniper. It happened on the 17th of January 2017. He left our mother's house and was walking down the street. He got shot down by a sniper. We wanted to get a hold of the body, but we couldn't. The next day, OSCE workers got his body. Oleg almost died himself. I was wounded too. I still have 11 pieces of shrapnel on my back. In 2015, on the border guard day, 3 grenades ended up in our yard. The power supply to the village has been restored. For 2 weeks, the locals lived without any electricity. The power line was damaged during the shelling. Ukrainian soldiers started delivering food to the village. They also brought more than 100 copies of Ukrainian newspapers. So that people know what is going on in the country and around it, in the international arena. People didn't know what the situation was like before. The positions of the Russian hybrid forces are just several hundred meters away. From time to time, the locals hear the sounds of shooting. Yesterday there was shooting. The militants used small arms to attack our positions and checkpoints. We are working hard on strengthening our positions. We are making trenches and building up fortifications. While soldiers are setting up their positions, local authorities are learning about the needs of the people who live there. They're planning to deliver medicine and building materials and to repair the roads.